Hey.
Hi.
Happy Saturday. What's good? We be playing Ace Attorney and shit. My mods were worried about me because I was meowing in pre-chat.
Meow meow. Meow meow meow.
Sometimes you just need an outlet to meow a little bit, you know? Who else could I meow to, huh? Welcome to Gamer Chair Anonymous. How are we taking the change? Bruh. Okay. I tweeted about this earlier today. That's what they're referring to. I have finally upgraded from gamer chair, scam chair, to an actual office chair. And it's lovely. I just want to sit in it. It's nice. I don't even think it's like a high, it's not even like a high-end office chair or anything. It's just like a mesh office chair that I bought off of Amazon. You use a yoga ball since 2020? Yo, how is that? I've heard of people doing that before. Oh yeah, chat, it's an upgrade. Don't even think it is an upgrade. I don't even think the gamer chair that I had, it was like a fucking S-Racer. It was like an off-brand one. Hey, thanks for the bits. Big Sword, Little Man. Thanks, Dragon Bob. Thanks, Lumo Blaze. Thanks, Joanne Lark. Thanks, Vivacious F. Thanks, Ducat Bucket. Thanks, Aloterium. Thanks, Chupins. Thanks, Mike and Ike. Thanks, Swain. Thanks, Handelon for the bits. Thanks, Big Sword Man. Thanks, Gamer. Thanks, Leap Pandas. Thanks, Okar. Thanks, Big Sword, Little Man. Again, thanks, Black Soul. That. Thanks, Klizzer. Thanks, Karto. Thanks, IU Glue. Okay, hi. Breathe? No, I can talk. I can talk and read fast, chat. I don't need to breathe. Even if I like exaggerate, like a after I'm done, I'm a rap god. Say epitome. Okay. Owned. You lose that ability in your 30s? No way! No. No, it has to be the opposite, right? Because by the time you're in your 30s, you should have, like, exercised your lung capacity enough that you have a bigger lung capacity. That's absolutely not how that works. But... Anyways, hi, hello. For those of you who missed the last time we played this, yo, thanks for the tier 3 Vito, thank you. How is the progress on the body going? Hey, I'm gonna be completely fucking real, Gyrus. I thought you were like, so how is, like, dieting and working out going for you? okay, listen, for context, they're referring to my Live 2D art that I did take the past couple of days to do, for my model art. But the first thing I thought when I saw that was, you mean, like, yo, what's up, Nio? Hey, what's good? What's good? Also, welcome, Grim. I don't lift, chat. I don't lift and I don't have abs, okay? I'm soft. I'm soft, man. Oh, they want to know about the body I have in the basement. Actually, speaking of which... Hang on. Speaking of which, my room was smelling weird and I couldn't figure it. Like, until I found a dead guy behind my community aquarium that like jumped out. So like I threw it out, I got rid of it, but my room still smells a little funny. And that was today. That was today I found a little dead guy behind my aquarium. Did he have a name? No, just a little dead guy. Got rid of him. But he was like decaying back there. He was decaying back there, bro. Like a gnome? Nah, just like a little fish. Just like a little fish that was like decaying in my room somewhere. So I'm just trying to ignore it. It doesn't smell that strong or anything. But it still smells like... this is very hard to describe. It smells dusty in my room. How does that happen? Sometimes they jump out. Sometimes they just jump out. It doesn't happen very often. Like, even the reason like I didn't have a lid was because I don't think I'd ever had a fish jump out of my community aquarium. But that one did. That one did jump out. And keeled over and died back there. Fucking, I guess L. I guess maybe don't jump out of the aquarium. I guess maybe don't exit the water into a place with no water. Fucking idiot. You live like that? Well, no. It's not like I left it there, chat. It was like that day. Like, this was today. I was like, something smells weird. And I instantly started investigating, right? I took out the trash. I checked the refrigerator. I made sure I didn't have any, like non-dry garbage, like, in my room. Like, things that weren't just fucking napkins or whatever. And then I checked behind the aquarium and I found it. You said it was decaying. Yeah! It was, and it just started smelling. It didn't smell like anything before today. I'm sorry. This is just, man, this is a bad start to our Saturday stream. Hi, let's start over. sorry for talking about dead, decaying fish for like a few minutes. I'm sorry. I have worked on my live 2D art. And that'll probably... I'll be ready to rig the torso on Thursday for sure, okay? So we'll get back on our live 2D streams. Oh god. It's actually like... I'm kind of already done with the torso art, so I think... I might even have time to do the legs by the time Thursday comes around. Probably not, but I could. But I might. Did you already start redrawing the beep ears? No, that's still on the pipeline, baby. That's still on the pipeline. Okay, chat, remember when I had little wing ears on the Meep model? Boxod like tweeted a clip and I really like, it's so fucking cute. It's so fucking cute. And I kind of pine for them. So I think I'm gonna bring them back. And I might make them toggleable because I feel like if I add the Meep ears onto the Racing Queen head, I feel like it might get slightly over-designed. But we'll see, okay? We'll see. I'm still gonna add them. I just might make them toggleable or something. They were so cute. They were so cute. And I missed them, chat. I did. I pine for it. Teehee. Anyways, we played Ace Attorney back a couple of weeks ago, or Apollo Justice a couple of weeks ago, as a sponsored stream, and we did the first case. But now I'm gonna continue it because we need a new thing for our Saturday streams anyways, and that's what we're gonna do. Let me just oh, boop, 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 boop. It's been almost a month, no? Wait, what? Has it? Oh god. Oh fuck. Wait, oh shit. Has it? It has? No, 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 no! Okay, no, it's fine. We finished Psy and then we took a week off. Yeah, but that's like... But no, 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 we're talking about when we played Apollo Justice. The intro. The intro, I mean like the first case, you know? The first case is pretty short. We got it done in one stream because it's also kind of a tutorial case. But I'll do a little recap because there are plot relevant things that happened in the case that are going to be relevant for the rest of the story, I believe. Important. Pay attention. Also, I haven't played Apollo Justice before. I've played the original Ace Attorney trilogy, and I'm a huge fan of it. I fucking love Ace Attorney. But this is all new to me, baby. Last time on Apollo Justice. Hold on. Adieu. Paralegal, unsurprisingly a fan of law. Real! Real! Real and true. I love that shit. I fuck with it. I fuck with it. Got into Monster Hunter Stories and the brain rot is strong. Say hi to my red Kizu. I heard- didn't Monster Hunter Stories just get like put on, like Steam or something? I think Monster- or- yeah, I think Monster Hunter- oh, Switch. Switch. I think the first one is better than the second one. I don't know. I don't even know why. Maybe it was because I was younger when I played it. But I liked the story a lot better. It was like, I don't know. Whatever. I have takes. Anyways. Yeah, it's Kino. For real. It's good. It's good. Apollo Justice killed Phoenix Wright. Wrong. In the tutorial case, we were introduced to our main character, Apollo Justice, a fledgling defense attorney, and his mentor, Gavin something. We find out throughout the trial that Gavin Clavier was attempting to frame Phoenix for murder. For reasons that we do not understand. Phoenix Wright has not been practicing law for 7 years because 7 years ago he lost his license. Oh, it was Kristoff? Wait, what? Wait, who is he? Gavin or Kristoff? Which one? Yeah, this is the sequel to Saya no Uta. Another classic by Urobuchi, Apollo Justice. Kristoff Gavin, thank you. Kristoff Gavin, yeah, that's his name. My bad. Kristoff Gavin attempted to frame Phoenix for murder for reasons unknown. Phoenix lost his attorney license, or license to practice law 7 years ago, also for unknown reasons, but also for reasons maybe involving Gavin Kristoff. And now I think we're gonna work for Phoenix and find out more on this episode of Apollo Justice. Yeah, this is the sequel to Song of Saya. Wait, hold on. Where are we? I think this was our manual save. Let's go, baby! How are the levels, chat? How are the levels? Also, Phoenix has a daughter, but is it actually his daughter? I feel like it's not his biological daughter. I don't really know. I also haven't seen Maya around yet. Or Edgeworth. We don't know anything about that. Not yet. By the way, when we see Edgeworth, I'm gonna scream, dude. I fucking love Edgeworth. All right, let's go. Let's fucking get it. Let me move my fat head, maybe. Oh. As long as we draw breath, the wheel of fate turns. Oh, is Phoenix getting into another case? Oh, what? Spinning big crimes and little crimes together. And when the wheel stops... What? You die. What? Huh? Huh? June 15th, 9:12 a.m. Wright & Co. Law Offices. 2 months have passed since- Oh wait, hold on, Apollo's voice. Oh fuck, this is gonna hurt me. 2 months have passed since Mr. Gavin's arrest. My first trial, and I lost both my mentor and my job. Yeah, I'll admit it, I was screwed. But even when I hit bottom, I told myself I'd never come here. Honest. Wait, hold on, will you what? Will you have as much passion for Edgeworth as you did for the frog? Probably not, man. I asked if she wanted to see clips and she said no. Yeah, I don't I don't wanna know. I was like fine though. I was barely hungover. You got quite silly. You're silly. Yeah, I don't live in the past. I just look to the future. You know? Like tomorrow, Sunday, again. Anyways. Here being the legendary Wright & Co. Law Offices. Okay, Justice, time to stop trembling. Ah, you must be here for the interview, right this way. Huh? If you saw it, we might have lost another VOD. You're exaggerating. Hello there, you found the right place. Welcome. What's with this girl? Is this Danganronpa? Kind of, yeah. I have something big to show you tomorrow. Oh yeah? Cool. Looking forward to it. Well now, shall we begin? Begin? What? We saw how you gnashed that nerd's rope. I was hoping it would be stretchier. I thought it would be funny if I had to like yank it around. Okay, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna read. Stop distracting me. Stop it. Right, first things first. Any special talents? Talents? Yeah, well, you must have at least one. Well, I guess defending? Defending. An unusual talent, but it'll do. With a little jazzing up, of course. You think so? Let's give it a go, shall we? Huh? Go ahead, show me. Defend. Just give it all you've got. Don't hold back now. What are you talking about? I can't just defend here. First lesson. A professional can perform anywhere. Thanks. We want people to be laughing with us, not at us. Thanks. But I'm not sure why they should be laughing at all. What? What exactly do you think you came here to do? What? Defend. No? Excuse me, but do you know where you are? Huh? The Wright & Co. Law Offices, right? Oh. I was afraid of that. Don't worry, you're not the first. Look, what's going on here? Who are you? I came here to meet with the person in charge. Well, you've apparently made no fewer than 2 mistakes. Mistakes? But I got a call from Mr. Wright this morning. Is Phoenix running a fucking comedy club now? What's going on? Magic show? Perhaps you should go read the sign out front again. What's there to read? Look, it says right there. Oh. Why does it say right talent agency?
Phoenix. No!
He's always running a comedy show.
Real true.
Welcome to the Right Talent Agency, where you've always come to the right place. I'm Trucy Wright, CEO. I'm a magician. It all came flooding back. The trial. That girl. Hello, sir. Please pick a card. She's so little here. So small. That's right. She's my daughter. Trucy Wright. Here, check out her flyer. So, what's your name? Apollo Justice? Attorney at Law.
Oh, shit.
So, is this really a talent agency? You bet. Daddy started it 7 years ago when he quit law. Can I just say dad chat? Of course, we only have 2 people signed up right now. 2 people? Does that include you? No? Okay, fine. Trucy Wright, magician extraordinaire. I've done a lot of stage shows, paid too. I'm a professional, you know? Right. Promise you'll come to one of my shows, okay? Let's see. Oh, and the other person our agency represents is... Phoenix Wright, pianist extra extraordinaire. Your dad, in other words. Didn't he say he couldn't play the piano? Our agency doesn't see that as a problem.
Oh my god, he's running a clown show!
Why, there are many magicians who can't do magic. At least you're optimistic. I'll give you that. So you're his, you're Phoenix Wright's daughter? That's right. After Daddy quit law 7 years ago, I promised I would keep him fed. See, I knew she wasn't actually his daughter. I knew that she was, like, adopted or something. So I'm kind of his sugar daddy. Get it? Trucy! No. I'm in charge of this whole office, too. Pretty amazing for a young lass of 15, wouldn't you agree? 15? How old is Mr. Wright? Daddy? He's 33 this year. I'm sure there's a good explanation. I hope. About Mr. Wright giving up law?
Yeah, you think Phoenix, like, hoed around when he was, like, 18 or whatever? No, I think Phoenix was a total hoe, but I really think she's just, like, adopted. He only has feelings for Edgeworth. Whoa, true?
It was because of that incident 7 years ago, wasn't it? Eh? You know about that? Not the details? I remember the news, though. It was a big deal. So I hear. I was too young to understand what was going on. I'll ask Daddy about it next time I get a chance. Daddy, right. That reminds me. About Mr. Wright? He gave me a call this morning to come in. Daddy's not here right now. He's in the hospital.
The hospital?
Yeah. He's on strict bed rest until he gets better. What? Okay, which hospital is Mr. Wright in? I'll pay him a visit. Oh, the Hickfield Clinic. It's quite close. Right, well, I'll be going now, and, give this showbiz gig some thought, okay? Wait, I'll go with you.
He's dying!
June 15th, 9:45 a.m., Hickfield Clinic.
Damn, that's a lot of DVDs.
So, this is Mr. Wright's hospital.
Jesus fucking Christ! Visitors, are you?
Yeah, are you the doctor?
Yep, Dr. Hickfield's the name. I hate him. Good morning, Doctor.
Oh, hiya there, Trucy. Cute as ever. I hate him.
Why is everyone saying my boy? Why is everyone saying my boy? Is he a good boy? He might be a good boy. We'll see.
Is this Daddy's room?
Oh, yeah. Except he's gone for a morning checkup. Be back soon. How are you, Miss Trucy? Got any places you'd like... Hickfield!
Doctor, the nurse was looking for you.
Why, if it isn't the Daddy, is the cutest little thing in town. Guess I'll be off then. Later, Trucy.
Wow, what an odd bird that guy was. Good morning. Didn't expect you so soon, Apollo. Mr. Wright. Do I have anything in my folder? Oh, just my badge. Is there anything to examine here? Is there like a ping I can do?
Mr. Wright's bed, it's really messy. Look how messy this is! You're just hopeless without me, aren't you, Daddy?
I hate saying that word! It's so gross! I never even said that when I was a kid!
Yikes, she's attempting to clean up! Look out!
You got me. What can I say? I was raised in a barn. Try not to let word get out, Apollo, if you don't mind.
Yeah, I might ruin your illustrious career pretending to play the piano.
Hey, chat! Isn't there usually like a button that'll be like that'll show you all the things in a room you can examine? Or am I getting it crossed over with Danganronpa? Am I getting things confused here? Just Danganronpa. Okay. Maybe
you snuck in grape juice again? The doctor said you weren't supposed to drink that here.
Trucy, look at the label.
Oh. Deep sea mineral water. That's fine, I guess.
I switched the labels. Don't tell Trucy, okay?
What can I say? The man loves his grape juice.
Hell yeah, Phoenix. Hell yeah. I think this will just show me things I can't examine. It'll do like a little ping.
A swaying, spiraling stack of DVD cases.
The Steel Samurai. The Nickel Samurai. The Pink Princess, the Zappy Samurai Electric Bugaboo.
They're all children's action hero shows.
This kid I know keeps sending them to me.
Huh, like a niece or nephew?
Something like that. Quite the collection. This kid's parents must be really generous with their allowance.
Funny, Mr. Wright doesn't seem the type the kids would like. What's that on TV? Looks like some sort of action hero show.
Oh, I know that one. That's the Sniffling Samurai. The... Why he's sniffling, though?
His booger flick attack is a big hit with the grade school crowd. I had no idea you liked this kind of stuff, Mr. Wright.
Well, what else is there to do when you're stuck in bed? Besides, the episodes will just keep piling up if I don't keep up, you know?
Yeah.
Now's the only time I get to watch and write up my reports.
Your reports?
It's a long story. Like a lot of things, actually. This poor bastard. I thought this game was about law. It is. Well, no, it's really about murder.
What happened?
Who could have imagined it? Me, victim of a hit and run.
You were hit by a car?
Oh, he tried to swerve. I'll give him that. Picture me tossed 30 feet through the air. Only stopping when my head hit that telephone pole.
You hit a telephone pole with your head? Are you okay?
Thankfully, my only injury was a sprained ankle.
He really is as lucky as they say.
There's something that, well, it just doesn't sit right. I just can't believe you have a daughter, Mr. Wright. Yeah, you only like men. She's so big, not fat, but you know what I mean.
Oh, Trucy's still a child.
How many times do I have to remind you? I'm not a child anymore.
But you'll always be daddy's little baby girl to me, Trucy.
My foot, I'm not buying it.
Oh, something you should know about Trucy? She's a magician.
She's a magician, right? She told me.
Not a mere stage magician. She's a genius.
Aww.
You'll soon come to appreciate her talent.
You could just tell me things instead of insinuating them. So why did you contact me? What could the right talent agency possibly want with me?
No need to get prickly now.
Hey, I didn't ask to be dragged in like this.
Huh? But didn't you come into the office of your own free will anyway?
Well, yeah, of course. Help! We're in big trouble here at the office! Big! I thought someone was dying.
So you don't think this is big trouble? My talent agency represents only two people, and one of them is in the hospital.
That's right. How are we gonna pay this month's rent? And the groceries?
Yeah, that's the problem with such a tight operation. It's a symbiotic relationship. When one of us falls, the other two must fall.
Say the word, streamer. Fine! Hey, this isn't exactly a suitable conversation to be having with a 15-year-old kid.
In any case, if Apollo here can't help you, you'll just have to transfer to a new school. Again.
No, I can't. I only just made friends. How could you do this to me? To us! Polly! Huh? What? Now it's my fault?
On that note, how about you come work for us? I've got the perfect client for you already lined up.
A client? You mean I get to do my job? I get to defend in court? Alright. I'll hear what you have to say. You got him, Daddy. Hook, line, and sinker.
Now it's time to reel him in.
It's official. I'm scared. Alright, who's the client?
Yeah. Here, take a look at the map and I'll explain. Last night I left the office just before 9 o'clock. I was going to that... Indochine pasta joint? Al Dente's? I play piano there, of course. That's when it happened. The car sent me flying, nicked a telephone pole, and zoomed away. Creepy, huh?
Just a tad. It's almost as creepy as hearing you tell the story like it was no big deal.
The car sped off in this direction. So, good luck.
Huh?
You wanted a client, didn't you? Well, I'm your client. Find the guy who knocked me into that telephone pole.
Whoa, hold on. I'm a defense attorney, not a detective.
Don't worry. Once you found the guy, I intend to sue him. Then you can stick it to him in court.
I'm not a prosecutor either. I'm sorry, but this is crazy. I'm going home.
Don't get so worked up. It was just a joke.
Huh? Oh, Daddy. Sorry, Apollo. He just loves jokes, you know? Even the ones that aren't very funny.
Your real client should be stopping by the office anytime now.
The office? You mean the talent agency? No harm in going. It's not like I have anything else to do.
One more thing. Do look into my accident too, would you? I marked the scene of the tragedy on this map.
He's so fucking cryptic. Why is he so fucking cryptic?
He wasn't this cryptic in the original trilogy. He's been traumatized by something. It's right in front of this park. Should be easy to find.
So he's gonna make me investigate this after all.
Alright, bye! Bye! Derma collab win. I remember when people used to call me, like, VTuber Derma. I remember that. Where are we going? June 15th, 10.05 a.m. Right, Talent Agency. Hey, hey, hey! Yeah, I fell off, man. Stop. Stop it. How long you planning on making me wait, eh? Oh.
Ah, good morning.
Who the fuck are you? Oh my god! Oh my god, chat! I was like, his hair looks like ramen. And then I looked at his head. It's a bowl of ramen! It's a bowl of ramen, chat! Fuck, what is this voice gonna be? Hey there, Trucy doll. Hey there. Maybe Southern drawl, maybe? I don't know. I don't know what to give this guy. Hey there, Trucy doll. Sounds like your pops had a bit of a rough spot, eh? I'm gonna slurp him! Wait, I kinda want ramen. Maybe I should order ramen later. Why does he have a suspiciously sized guillotine? Huh? Oh my god, I missed it. All's well that ends well, I guess. This is our client? Guillotine? Oh shit! Wait, oh my god, he has like a guillotine for like rats! Make him sound like Everart, please. Okay, I can try. Hey, so this is that Paulo fellow, eh? Is that close? I haven't listened to Everart in a hot second.
Oh, yes?
Look at him there, arms all crossed-like, ready to fight.
Yes, sir. You don't mean that literally, do you?
The boss told you what I need, right? Don't let me down now, Paulo.
Don't worry about your defense, sir. I'm on it.
Defense? Your noodle half-cooked? Your noodle half-cooked! His fucking ramen hair! I hate him. I kind of like him. You sure that's for rats? What could it possibly be for? Pick one. No, I can have both. My castle's been stormed! My keep's been kept! My noodle stand's been stolen!
Noodle? You know Mr. Eldune from the noodle stand, don't you, Polly? No nicknames, please! And no, of course I don't know him!
You new in these parts?
Not really.
Then you know the best noodles in town, Eldune's Noodles!
Whose noodles?
My noodles! Help me out here, Trucy doll.
This is Mr. Guy Eldune, our client. Maybe you can tell us what the problem is, Mr. Eldune.
His name is Noodle Backwards. Oh, fucking, of course it is.
He uses his little harmonica.
Anything for you, Trucy doll. Hey, let's examine. Hey,
there are all sorts of strange paraphernalia sitting on top of the piano. Those are my magic props. Practice, practice, practice. A professional never leaves their weapons far from reach. But you can't play the piano with all this junk on it. Oh, no one plays here anyway, and the neighbors complain. I guess Mr. Wright really can't play.
Is that your hat?
A blue silk hat, just like the one Trucy's wearing. Oh, that's just for show. Don't wear it, please. Last off from my mind, honest.
Yeah, but she has fucking lice.
Nothing says magician like a silk top hat.
What the fuck is this?
A strange split box leers at me from the wall. Is this one of those boxes for cutting people in half? That's right! This cabinet is used for an illusion called the zigzag.
Oh, fuck.
I've seen
seen one on TV, but why is one just sitting here in your office?
Oh, it's a little big for me, you see. So I'm using it as furniture. Hats in the top, shirts in the middle, pants down below. I think it's a nice touch, don't you?
It's not exactly what I'd call a welcoming decor.
That table doesn't look very sturdy.
You've never seen one of these?
It's a magic table.
So, like, you make this teapot disappear?
So you might think, but that's not it.
Before your very eyes, the contents of the pot change. From Earl Grey to Darjeeling.
Kinda hard to say the difference, I think.
Oh, well, holy shit! Is that a floating spaghetti? Whoa, that fork is floating!
Not. Why do you have a plate of plastic spaghetti here?
That right there is the whole reason I became a magician.
Do tell.
I saw a plate just like that in a restaurant once. The floating fork looked so real. That's when I knew. Someday, I'd make magic more amazing than that spaghetti.
Okay.
So, you run a noodle stand, Mr. Eldoon.
Guy Eldoon's the name, and noodles are my game. The secret's in the soup. I've been searching for the perfect soup for a year and a half.
Oh, that's not that long, really.
My family's been noodle men for generations, got a lot of expectation on my shoulders. 15 fathers passing the noodle to 15 sons.
That's a pretty old noodle.
Aye, and fool that I was, I pushed it away. I rebelled against my pops and picked another livelihood. But that didn't turn out so well.
Oh.
There was no denying it. Salty broth runs through these veins, boy.
So, it was like destiny that you became what you are.
Right, destiny is the word. Oh, I fought it. But in the end, I was bound by the twisted noodle of fate.
Not a mental image I care to linger on.
So, last year I started my noodle stand. The 15th generation of Eldoon's noodles.
So tell me more about Eldoon's noodles.
You don't know the genius that are my noodles. I make them so salty, why, they're saltier than salt.
Now I really don't want to find out.
Daddy's a regular at his noodle stand.
He frequented my pop's stand back in during his attorney days, too. Yep, him and his assistant.
Maya! Where is she? Where is Maya?
Okay.
I'm sorry, I'll be sure to drop by your stand soon.
Thanks for the 10,000 bits, K. Holy shit, thank you. Please never say daddy again. I am begging you.
I have to. It's the dialogue in the game.
I don't like saying it. I don't like saying it, K. I don't love saying it under any context at all. I did skip a couple, then people got mad at me. Minus 10k? You deny it? I don't know, chat. I can't pick favorites.
Why do I like Maya so much? Is because she's a fellow girl failure? It's because she was Phoenix's companion for 3 games, but we don't know where she is right now.
And I like her. I know she's like, she sort of like falls into the trope of like awkward, silly girl who loves to eat cheeseburgers, but I love that for her.
Wish you could, Sunny.
Huh?
Heck, I wish I could. I'd give anything for a bowl about now.
What do you mean?
It was stolen! My stand! Gone!
Stolen?
It was last night. I was doing my rounds, blowing my whistle.
It's like an ice cream truck's bell, but louder. He even gets complaints.
Now you're just trying to butter me up.
That sounded more like the blues than a whistle.
I closed up my stand for the night and parked by the house. Then, this morning, dark and early, it was gone! My keep! My castle! Oh!
Maybe some bum carted it off? Just guessing here.
Well, I don't care who did it. Without that stand, I'm finished. All my noodle bowls were in there too.
That's the saddest thing I've heard all day.
You know it. Anyhow, that's the deal. Good luck.
Good, huh? Wait, what exactly is your request?
My noodle stand. Find it, Harry. And the day you bring my baby back is the day you get your gun back. Of course. I make it so hot and salty, two bowls would kill a man. Then I'd really need defense.
Speaking of defense, that's what I do. I'm a lawyer, not a detective.
This is where I live. You drop by if you need any info, okay?
Fuck yeah, little dude. Fuck yeah.
Get it back today if you can, Paulo. I got noodles to make.
Things have certainly taken a turn for the bazaar. Traffic accidents and a noodle stand thieves. Actually, there was something I wanted to ask you about, too, Apollo. Huh?
Hey, listen to the lady's problem now. Don't be cruel.
I lost something last night. That is, something was stolen.
Hey, what's this? More thieving and skullduggery.
Well, someone stole a pair of my panties. Panties? So they were stolen. My panties. Yes. Right. Panties.
That's a crying shame, that is, Trucy doll.
I was alone in the office last night. I'd hung my panties out the window there to dry.
Looks towards camera.
When a thief came and took them, my favorite panties! I ran after him. Give those back, I shouted. Wait! Well, that was certainly brave of you. But I lost him. Without those panties, I don't know what I'll do.
A darn crying shame. Yup.
Well, at least the scene of the crime is convenient.
No way all these three are connected. Ain't no way.
I'll mark it on your map.
I'll be heading home now. Remember, find my stand or there's an empty bowl in your future, Paulo.
Right.
And you help out Trucy doll here too, you hear?
No, oh, I like Noodle Guy. I like Noodle Guy.
Things have certainly picked up, haven't they? We had no work since yesterday, and now we have three cases.
I guess?
Let's see where we stand.
Not in a courtroom. That's where.
Well, the first item on our list. Phoenix Wright, Daddy's hit and run accident. We have to find the one who hit him. Who's gonna pay us for this again? And the second item. Mr. Eldoon's request to find his stolen stand. For which we stand to gain a bowl of salty noodles. And the last request is mine, to find my stolen panties. That bowl of noodles is looking better and better. Let's go, Polly, to the streets! Aren't you enthusiastic? How could I not be? Let's crack these cases, you and me! Guess we might as well get started. Let's see, a hit and run, a stolen stand, and last but not least, stolen panties. Well, Apollo, let's start with... Well, actually, maybe Phoenix has something to say.
Huh? Mr. Wright's gone. Maybe he's gone for an examination. He'll probably be back soon. Let's wait. I think it might take some time. Daddy always loves his examinations. Don't ask, Justice. You don't want to know. Why don't we come back later? Yeah, I guess you're right. I don't...
Phoenix! There's something wrong with that guy.
So this is where Mr. Wright got hit by that car. According to the map, this is the place. What a huge mansion. Apollo, there's a nice looking lady over there. Let's question her. Okay. I'm a little curious about... the park over there, too.
Mr. Everard is helping me find my panties. Oh shit, she looks like a thumb!
Excuse me, can we have a few words with you?
You want something?
Wait, oh, does she have like a sexy voice?
Whoa, that husky voice. Why am I suddenly sweating? That's quite a house you've got there. You must have a lot of money.
I don't, chat, I'm not gonna do a, I can't, I don't want, I don't, I. I don't want to do. Do your best sexy gilf voice. What, like, what does a gilf say? Like, oh my fucking god, I'm gonna kill myself. Hold on. If there was, I don't know, I've never met one. If there was a tractor trailer hurtling towards me at this very moment, I don't think I would step out of the way. I think I would let it take me. Okay, fuck. Joyce voice. Want some hard candy, sweetie? I don't fucking know. I can't do it. Money sounds like something my son would call his friends. Fuck, I have to give her a voice. Like Sam trying to do a Scottish lady accent. I think his Scottish lady accent is good the times that I've heard it. Stop staring at me. I can't do it. I'm a coward. Stop staring at me. Toad voice? I can't do that for 2 more hours?
This is the Kentucky Family Mansion, little girl!
This is the Kentucky Family Mansion, little girl. No, that's not good either.
Okay, how low can I get my voice? You kid with the hair, you want something? I can't do this.
Me? Not a thing. Bye. Apollo, we can't leave without questioning her. What if she knows something? But the Kentucky family, they're the biggest organized crime syndicate in town. Oh shit.
If you're gonna ask something, ask it! If you're man enough!
Right! Yay, way to whip him into shape, ma'am! Does she know no fear?
I'm Plum! Plum Kentucky! Wife of the 4th head of the Kentucky family business! Friends call me a little Plum!
I'm Little Apollo Justice, attorney at law. Oh, guys. If looks could kill, this woman would be a mass murderer.
Little Plum, that's a really cute name for someone so...
Yes!
Wow. What is it, Apollo? How about you go through me when talking to her, okay, Trucy? Huh? That seems like a bit of needless procedure.
I'm a lawyer. I live for needless procedures.
To help you out, think of her voice as Patrick Starr, but female and deep.
I can't do that! I can't. I don't. I'm not gonna do a fucking MILF voice.
Oh, little girl, you should know. We're gangsters.
I also can't keep the Toad voice because I know she's gonna be a witness in this trial and I'm gonna have to keep doing it.
Gangst. Oh, that means you're the bad guys. Trucy, through me, please.
The bad guys. I like the sound of that.
I'm gonna need some warm tea after this.
It takes a lot of hard work to protect a family fortune. Things aren't as easy as they used to be for us bad guys.
So you're saying that business is in a slump? Let's not ask about business if we can help it, please. So there was supposedly a car accident here last night?
Last night?
Of course you wouldn't know about it. Sorry to bother you.
Wait.
Yes?
You're talking about that man, aren't you? The one who flew 30 feet and just walked away?
That's my daddy.
I should have known. One of our capos thought he'd make a great point, man. He'd make a great point. What's a point, man?
Capo? Point, man? Could you avoid using too much, industry lingo?
In any case, it's been nothing but trouble. I've been cleaning up this mess since morning. Ugh.
Cleaning up this paint? Was this paint spilled at the time of the accident?
It was around 9 last night. I heard a crashing noise. I found your father drowning in a sea of paint.
Oh, that's weird. So you came to his rescue?
You've my husband, the boss, to thank for that. The car that hit your father knocked over this paint. Then turned the corner and sped away. We're in the middle of repainting our wall, you see.
I'm sure that dragon is glaring at me. But why are you out here cleaning it up?
What do you mean?
I mean, aren't you a gangster? Don't you have any goons to do your dirty work for you?
Please, go through me when you want to- Don't be such a stiff lawyer boy. I suppose we gangsters do have a certain image.
Yeah.
But we're community-oriented gangsters, you see? The boss likes to give back to the people, see?
How noble of him.
I availed myself to the public facilities to get rid of all the garbage. Now there's just the paint on the street to deal with.
Public facilities? I wonder if she means that trash can.
Huh.
Phoenix didn't mention any paint.
Ugh.
A brightly colored, a painted dragon. Why do I get the feeling he's staring at me? Those paints must have been to repaint this wall.
That's right. I called in an artist to do the job right. He's the third so far.
The third? The first spilled paint all over the entrance here. The second on my kimono. So I...
No, don't tell me! It's better that I don't know.
Did you kill him? Plum, did you kill him?
Wow, what a big house! And the gate is so big!
The Kotaki family is pretty big around these parts.
I like the fox, it's so cute!
Ah, that's our family crest from the old country.
Your family crest?
Well, clever as the fox, and our teeth are sharp.
So it's like a motto. You need a crest too, Apollo. Ooh, how about the Scales of Justice, or Lunar Lander?
I'll pass, thanks.
There's paint splashed all over this gate. What a mess.
Was this paint knocked over by the car that hit my daddy?
That's right. And I'm left to clean up the mess. You find out whoever did this, bring the scoundrel by, won't you?
Of course! Then you can make them clean up their own mess!
You're cute. Naive. But cute. When I find whoever did this, you can bet I'll be doing some cleaning. There's nothing I dislike so much as a mess.
Oh, I wish I could say cool things like that.
I'll bet you do.
I'd laugh if my teeth weren't chattering.
Hey, relax, Apollo. You haven't made enemies out of the fucking local syndicate yet. Hold on. Oh shit, that's where it is.
Oh, hi!
Who's that? She's looking at the park.
She's pretty. I bet she has a story, you know?
There is something about her. Too bad she seems to be in a bit of a rush.
Let me examine first. Are you guys- what the fuck? What's going on here?
Looks like there's some kind of trouble by the park gate. I smell an incident!
Ma'am, there's no entry to the park! Now don't you tell me where I can't go, young fella! I always walk through this park on my way home.
Please, get down from there. You'll hurt yourself, ma'am.
That's quite the determined old lady.
Yeah, never break up old people's routines, man.
Personally, I'm a little more interested in this park.
You know what I think? I bet they're filming a movie. Let's go take a look. Maybe we'll see someone famous.
Hey, miss, stay out of the park.
He got mad at me.
Did something happen here, officer?
Huh? No, move along. Nothing to see. Why don't you kids just go play somewhere else?
We're not kids, and we're not playing! I'm an attorney! I'm a VTuber!
Something wrong?
Detective Sky. We're fine, ma'am. Nothing to report.
Sky? Oh, shit! Oh my god! Yo! It's fucking Emma! She's so much bigger now! I love her tinted glasses. Bro, I should get tinted glasses.
Why is she wearing a lab coat?
You're hardly one to comment on how people are dressed.
Okay, shit. How do I do... I wonder... Maybe she should have, like, a British accent, right?
These kids are...
Curiosity seekers.
Ma'am, they claim to be the lawyers. I'll figure it out. I don't know how to, but I'll figure it out.
Ah, why don't you kids run along and play someplace else? Why don't you?
I don't know how. She does kind of, no, she doesn't really look like Mari.
Somewhere else. Look, we're not, or I might spill something on that pretty face of yours.
No, she can't be Cockney. She has to say pretty, not pretty, right? She has to be, fuck, I can't do it. I don't do.
Want a dose of experimental hydroglycosaminogen trace?
Pronounce every D and T and skew all vowels away from A and towards O.
Come again? What's...
F-
fuck! It's slipping. What's hydroxy stuff?
Whatever it is, it doesn't sound good. Let's go, Trucy.
Okay, hold on. I can do a Tommy voice, but I've done it. I've always done it with like a weird like throat inclination, so I don't know how to do it normally.
Try to keep out the riffraff, if you would. Try to keep out. Keep out. Is it keep? Keep out?
Keep out.
Keep out the riffraff, if you would.
Yes, ma'am.
How are we gonna get more information like this?
I knew you inclined your neck, I could hear it. Oh yeah, you have to, like, listen, any fucking voice I've ever done for a D&D character, I have to, like, do weird shit with my neck.
Why don't we ask that nice woman across the street? Oh yeah, that nice woman.
Oh, guys! Oh, guys!
There's a big trash can on the way into the park. I guess we could check it out. A detective's life sure is a hard one. I'm an attorney, actually. Huh? Two pieces of garbage with paint on them. These are slippers. They look like those slippers you get at the hospital. Look at this, Apollo. Doesn't this go on a car? It's a side view mirror. Looks like it was torn off when it smacked into something. Or someone. Wait, you don't think? I do. This could be that car that hit Mr. Wright. Wow, and he took off its mirror? I never knew Daddy was so strong. I actually have room in my pocket for one of these, though. Which do you want to take?
I guess it doesn't really matter, does it? I do not have old lady slippers, chat. I do have slippers, though, and I do wear them. It's because my feet get cold, okay?
There's some paint on the slippers in this trash can. I can only carry one thing at a time in my pocket.
Okay, so I guess they'll just give me the option to. What slippers do you have?
I don't know. They're like normal.
They're like slippers I got at Target. Like, they're just, honestly, they don't have a lot of structure. They're just kind of fluffy, and I just pull them on like socks. You know, because it's not like slipping on shoes. You kind of got to pull them over.
I gotta say, I'd really like to know what happened here.
Hey, I said no one goes in. Unless you want a face full of hydrozesus and what's it.
No dice.
People Park.
People Park. Huh. Kind of an odd name for such an empty place. I wonder why it's named that. Hey, there's something written on the gatepost. Huh? Oh yeah, it says donated by Big Wins Kentucky. You mean the Kentucky family built this park? It's so nice of them to give to the community like that. Let's not get too friendly with them, shall we? A gangster building a park? Odd move for a crime boss.
I can't... insist you wear the platform combat boots at all times to maintain the appropriate vibes. Guys, I don't have platformers. Like I do have like combat boots, but they aren't platformers. I don't need platformers. I'm 5'8 without platformers. I can hit almost 6 feet with heels. I got long ass legs. Don't doubt me. Guys, I don't like being tall. Why would I wear platformers? I mean, it's not that I don't like being tall. It's just that, like, you know, I just sometimes I just feel like a big, awkward Great Dane. That's all. Compared to other women, you know? Maybe let's ask her about the park.
If we can. Can I ask you a question?
What?
What happened in the park across the street? Oh, yes, quite the commotion. Chicago lightning, as the boss would say.
Chicago, huh?
Gunfire. Someone was killed. Strange circumstances, too.
You're kidding!
What a morning. Trouble everywhere. The park, the gate, even our house.
Does something happen at your house, too?
A crime without honor, without remorse. It's a private matter. Wanna hear about it?
She's so cool!
Somehow I don't think no is an acceptable answer, Polly.
Fucking me. Me, she's such a fucking yapper, dude. Hey, wanna hear about something really personal?
So, what happened at your house?
Bloomers. Last night.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Me, little Plum Kataki, the victim of a panty snatcher.
No! Not another one!
What? So it wasn't just my panties that were stolen?
Got you too, did they? Poor thing. Like I said, whoever did this is a hardened criminal. It wasn't you, was it?
No, of course not! Mercy!
I've heard word that panties have been disappearing lately. And the missing panties all have something in common.
It's hard to imagine Trucy and Mrs. Kataki's panties having much in common. You don't need to imagine shit, Apollo. Hey. I just imagine Mrs. Kataki's panties. Oh. I know. We'll find your bloomers, too.
Great. Show me what you're made of.
What have you gotten me into this time, Trucy? That girl from before.
Oh, welcome home, sweetie.
Hello, mother. She's a Kataki too? Miss.
She doesn't get a unique voice. I don't give a shit.
Here, our flyer. The Write Anything Agency.
A Valley accent? Valley accent.
Anything Agency?
Yeah. Do you like the new flyer?
So, this is our defense attorney, Mr. Apollo Justice.
Attorney? Attorney?
Drop by our office. We'll be waiting.
Goodbye.
Why did you give her our flyer?
I don't know. She seemed like she could use some help.
She's the heiress to a gangster dynasty. She doesn't need our help.
I wouldn't be so sure.
Why'd you nail it so well? Because I'm a white woman. Like, what do you want? Like... like... Hey, check this out, though. Wait. Oh, I could examine.
Can you tell me anything about this mirror?
That's probably from the car that knocked that fellow across the street.
Right, that makes this a valuable clue.
Let me know if you find that car, would you? You splash Kataki paint, you pay the price.
I feel like I should show her the slippers, shouldn't I? Let's just swap them out. I'm kind of annoyed that they don't just let me hold both items.
Righto! I just wanted to- I just want to ask her about the slippers.
Ah!
I thought she disappeared. Did I miss the paint by a pixel? Oh shit, hold on. Just give me a sec. Ooh, what? Okay, how do I readjust the pointer though? Hello? Oh, okay, I gotta use the keys.
The bottom is covered with paint. Huh? What's this weird shape here?
A leaf. Apollo.
Looks like a leaf was stuck to the bottom when the wearer stepped in some yellow paint. So the outline was left when the leaf was removed. Ah, I got some paint on my hand. Apollo, I saw you try to wipe your hand on my cape.
Oh, Apollo.
Oh, fuck. Sorry, kid. I got no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. I thought it said it. Okay. Maractus. I got it confused with Kitaki for some reason because they both had K's and T's and I's in it. Alright, well... Somebody said I missed the paint by just a millimeter. What does that mean? I think I got everything here. Whatever. On the mirror? Oh, shit. Wait, you're right. You're so right. You're right. What am I- Fuck! I put it back! I do need to examine the paint on it, you know? I need to look at it, okay? Okay. Oh, never mind. Okay. Anyways, hey, let's move on to the next scene. Scene of the stand theft.
So, what's this place?
This would be Mr. Eldude's house, silly.
So, this is where his stand was stolen from? I can see a piece of evidence laying on the ground already.
Dog.
Hey!
Three shots for the price of one. Oh, like vaccine. Wait. Why are people knowing me? What happened? What's going on? What did I miss, huh? Stop. It was the sign? Oh, the sign. I'll look in a sec.
Look, there's a police car parked over there. You're right. What's with the sparkly entrance? What is this place? A hospital? There's a sign. Maractis Clinic. Oh, that's where the thief went. The thief? The one who snatched my panties! He ran into this clinic last night! Wait, maybe the police car is here to find my panties!
Yeah, maybe, Tracy. Trucy, fuck.
I doubt it. Well, there's only one way to be sure. Let's investigate.
Ah, there you are, Harry! Well, you find anything yet?
No, not yet.
Oh, it does say no! new. Where is Dulce? The longer you loaf around here, the saltier your victory bowl gets. Just remember that.
bowl of noodles is sounding less like payment, more like a punishment.
Hey, boy! Let me examine for save the light. That's fucking weird.
There's a handwritten sign here. Save the light. Save the light, indeed. Mr. Eldude's house is practically in the dark here. I guess the hospital clinic next door blocks the sunlight.
Everything's gone wrong since they built this monstrosity. Broth needs sun or it rots. What's a man to do? They just want my customers to get food poisoning so they can turn a pretty profit.
That seems like a lot of trouble to go through for a few extra patients.
No!
Sir, you are a soup. True.
That's quite the sign. I take it that no! As opposed to old?
Old? Is this something? This might be something lost in translation. I'm gonna be real.
Ah, you like it. Made it myself, I did. I meant to write noodles, but ran out of space.
Oh, new instead of, okay, I get it.
Prior planning prevents poor performance.
Lucky for me, it spells a word all by itself and spruces up my image, it does.
It does have a certain power and willful denial thing going for it.
That's stupid. That's stupid.
This house is, well, it's old.
It's been well loved, that's for sure. I've lived here with my wife for many years now. It's got character though, just like my soup.
I always thought that character was a positive thing. Look, a doggy. Good boy, Salty. I'm sure the dog has a real name, Trucy.
Yep, sure does. Name's a spoon, and it's a she, by the way.
Spoon doesn't seem so lively.
She didn't get her bowl of salty broth this morning, that's why.
Poor little thing.
Apollo, let's find that stand soon, for Spoon's sake.
Spoon? Spoon? Spoon the dog, that's such a fucking good dog name, holy shit.
I'm pretty sure dogs aren't supposed to eat noodles.
Spoon.
That's the place, right here. That's where I kept my stand, covered all nice and pretty with that blue tarp there.
So you use this plastic sheet to cover your stand at night? I see. You see? What, did you figure out why it was stolen? Well, no, but it does suggest that the thief knew what he or she was looking for. They clearly knew what was under that sheet.
So it wasn't one of those casual drive-by stand snatchers, you mean? Not bad, Sonny boy. Not bad at all.
Bowl.
Is this yours, Mr. Eldune?
Hey, that there's the heart and soul of Eldune's noodles. The bowl absorbs my salty soup. Pretty soon it's gonna taste just like noodles.
Wow, it does smell like noodles. How often do you wash those? Hello?
All my other bowls got taken away with my stand.
He's sucking his hair! What the fuck?
Can I go back?
Get it back for me, Sonny boy! I'm begging you!
Jesus fucking Christ. Vote. Vote?
I'd understand if there was an ambulance outside, but why a police car? Maybe they're tax evaders.
Ah, sorry, miss. No going into the clinic today.
Does something happen?
Huh? Oh no. Nothing to see here. Move along. You'll have to find someplace else to play doctor.
Do we look like the right age to be playing doctor? We need a little more info on this Maractus clinic. We could ask Mr. Eldune. He's the neighbor and all. And we should check out that garage.
What if the thief who stole my panties is still in there?
Looks like they have a special offer going on.
3 shots for the price of 1? Ooh, now's our chance, Apollo!
Chance for what? I don't need any shots, thank you.
Whoever runs this clinic, they seem pretty business-minded.
That doorway sure is sparkly.
The Meraktis Clinic, huh? Looks more like a casino parlor than a hospital. Must have been quite profitable.
Funny, it looks closed. Maybe they're on vacation today?
Sus? I think that's suspicious. Probably.
Oh boy! So you're saying Eldoon's noodles, was it?
Aye, passed down from father to son. Has Stan seen its share of salt, mm-hmm. Salt runs in the family, you might say.
The high blood pressure does too. So your stand Eldoon's noodles was stolen.
Oh, it wasn't just the stand that was stolen, sonny boy. I lost those wobbly wheels, my salt-crusted stew pot, my stained sign. I didn't just lose a stand, I lost a legend.
No one steals a legend and gets away with it on my watch. Let's find that legend, Apollo.
Isn't it about time he brought a new one anyway?
Are there any more details you could give me about the stand?
You bet, sonny boy. It happened last night. I was blowing my whistle like always, crying the town I was.
Have a good one, Gopher.
The smell of broth filled the streets, thick and salty. I got home, well, right before 10 p.m., I reckon.
Guess he's not aiming for that late-night market.
I washed my bowls and gave the wheels a squirt of grease. Then I went inside.
When did you notice it had been stolen?
Early this morning, before the sun rose. Work starts early.
Do many people eat noodles for breakfast?
I'm washed up on the salty shores of ruination. That stand had my whole life in it. Nay, my whole being.
They took everything.
All my soup stock, my noodles, my bowls, and my dreams.
At least they left one bowl. Look, there on the ground.
If you don't find that stand today, then I'll be forced to walk the streets, peddling that bowl. My last bowl.
Please, I'm under enough pressure here as it is.
All my bowls gone.
That's it. That's where the thief who snatched my panties ran to.
It's a crying shame, that is. If they have to steal, make it my loincloth, not some pretty girl's panties.
The garage, right. You don't think the thief lives there, do you?
Theh! I wouldn't pat it past that good-for-nothing doctor.
Do I detect a little animosity here? Let's make sure to check out the garage thoroughly. Hey, do you think something happened next door? There's a police car out front.
Probably gave someone food poisoning, I'll bet.
If anyone's at risk of giving someone food poisoning...
The police car got here this morning, actually. I asked what they were up to, but they wouldn't even tell me. The neighbor. Not that I was surprised much. The doctor works for the wrong crowd. It was just a matter of time before he got what was coming to him.
The wrong crowd?
Never you mind about that. Fire Emblem Heroes.
Oh, fuck.
What if he... Hold on.
Oh, look! I love these little personal touches.
Seems a shame to hide it on the bottom of the bowl.
Huh?
When I touched the paint flaked off.
He must have painted it by hand with warm professional care.
After buying the cheapest paint you could find with cold professional thrift.
Owned.
It's the Eldoon Noodles mascot. Mr. Salty, he's so cute.
It's not a very endearing mascot, is it?
You know, come to think of it, it looks a lot like you, Apollo. Especially the red parts.
Can I help it if I like red?
Mr. Salty. Hey, thoughts on this?
You could tell my bowls by the Mr. Salty logo.
The mascot of Eldoon's Noodles.
They come to the stand, they sit, they drink deep from that bowl, and when they see the bottom, their face looks just like Mr. Salty's. Genius, no?
Very high concept.
You can't ply a trade if you don't love the tools. Remember that.
Yes, sir.
Tracy's a thing for professionals, clearly.
We need to show... Fuck! God damn it! Trucy, you... You're holding my goddamn slippers! You... Ho!
We probably have to move to the garage.
Thirsty.
This is the place. This is where that panty snatcher ran.
Cat.
Are you sure?
Maybe. Let's look for clues.
Clues to a panty snatching. Clues like a pair of panties. Jersey? Could you try not saying panties so many times?
What the fuck? Huh? What? Well, there's the broken mirror. Is that a fucking phone? Cat?
It was the cat! We found the culprit!
There's something about this car. Let's take a closer look.
Guys, come on. Come on! Come on!
Hey, look at that! The mirror's been broken off.
What? You're smiling like you know something I don't. You're not keeping a clue from me, are you, Polly?
A clue? Let's see.
Oh yeah, I guess it's a good thing I hung on to that then.
Take that!
Take that!
My clue is this! Bum bum bum!
Whoa, it's the same color and size and everything. A perfect match. Yo, what's up, Mr. Cow?
I guess we could check it out.
Flashback, flashback.
Looks like it was torn off when it smacked into something. Or someone. Well, looks like we've just solved a case. So the car that hit Daddy last night is sitting right in front of us.
Oh, it's sitting right in front of us. Yep, I'm Ash Ketchum.
Wow, you put the prone professional, Apollo.
Gee, thanks, Trucy.
She called us by her real name.
What the fuck?
That reminds me. I once read a record of a case that Mr. Wright worked on so many years ago. Apparently, there was this car with a piece of cloth shoved into the tailpipe. The piece of cloth turned out to be a vital clue to solving the case.
Wow.
I remember the case record whenever I'm checking out a car. And I always check the tailpipe. Everyone's gotta have a hobby, I guess. Wouldn't it be funny if... Hey, there's something in there!
What?
Wait a sec.
Are these your... Ah! My panties! What? Already? Huh? What? Wow, thank you, Apollo. You're a genius. Amazing. No, really, don't mention it. No, I'm serious. I'm really impressed. You must have a nose for finding girls' panties. Girl, what the fuck? What are those? My little panties, of course. They've come home to mama. Can't wait to use them. You're gonna put them on now? Watch closely now. See? Nothing in the panties? Ta-da! Whoa, where'd that come from? How did that bowl get in your panties? My panties are an extra-dimensional space. Anything can fit in there. They're my magic panties. It's one of my best tricks. Magic panties. They love them over at the Wonder Bar. I do shows there nightly. You mean those panties are a prop? You could have told me a little sooner.
Put discreetly away in Trucy's pocket. Thank God, man.
Well, that's one case closed at least. What are you saying? We still have to catch the sly devil that ran off with the tool of my trade. Oh, right. Something tells me we're not finished searching this garage. Yeah, no way. Is that a phone? Is that a switch? What is that? Look, a cell phone. Someone dropped it beneath this tire. If the car moved, it would have been crushed for sure. I wonder if it belongs to the doctor here. We should bring it to him later. Why does it have a watch on it? Huh? What is it? Now that we've solved the case, we should go report to Daddy. He'll mope if we leave him alone for too long, knowing him. Okay. He doesn't seem the type to mope. This is hardly a case worth reporting.
We ain't done here. We're not going anywhere. No way, man.
Look, it's a folding ladder. Polly, that's called a step ladder. Come on. A step ladder? How is it different from a regular ladder, then? It's a much more complex piece of machinery. It's like two ladders stuck together. So you admit that basically it's a ladder, right? Wait, huh? You have to look past the form at the essence of the thing. Can we talk about something else? Someone's there! Oh, it's just a cold painted human skeleton. Just a human skeleton in painted gold? There's a mannequin hand waving to us from the box behind the skeleton. This place just screams hospital storage, don't you think? It screams something, that's for sure.
What the fuck is going on here, man? Cat, hello?
Meow meow. Meow 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 meow. Hey, a kitty cat. You're kitty kitty.
The sticker on the box reads GILF. What? Where? Where? What are you talking about? Top box. Oh wait, I guess it kind of, it almost says GILF.
Meow. Not coming down. You do look kind of suspicious, you have to admit. It's okay, kitty cat. His hair won't hurt you. It's okay, kitty cat. She won't make you disappear in her hat.
Oh, cat doesn't want to hang out with us. Why live? Being rejected by a cat is one of the worst feelings in the universe. Couldn't
relate. Cats love me. I bet there's been one cat that didn't like you. Come on.
Phoenix!
Yo, how goes it?
Daddy, how do you feel?
Not bad, Trucy. Not bad. It's good to have you youngins on the case. Let's old daddy-o get some well-deserved R&R.
Am I gonna finish the entire case this stream? Hell no! Hell no, I heard this case was like 9 hours long.
I'll probably go into like 9 my time.
The elder need their rest.
Isn't he only 33?
We've cleared up most of the cases.
I was right about you. Competent. Capable. Tell me what you found out, if you want to.
Your enthusiasm is overwhelming.
Well, I certainly didn't expect you to be back this early.
Polly's amazing. He found my panties so quick. Almost like he was the one who stole them.
Girl! Do not!
You have an interesting concept of praise.
And? Did you find the mad driver who gave me that 30-foot toss?
Apparently, it was a doctor from the Maractus Clinic.
Hmm, Maractus, eh? I've heard of him. Nothing good, mind you.
That reminds me, a police car was parked outside the clinic. Maybe something happened? What is this Maractus Clinic, anyway?
A cat let me pick them up and pet them, and I felt like I was blessed by the gods.
God, I wish that were me! Oh, I wish that were me! Oh, I haven't touched a cat in years! Years!
All I've heard are the rumors. That clinic's been making good money in a bad way.
Bad?
Ties to organized crime. The Kentucky family.
The Kentucky family? He did that on purpose.
Some injuries you can't take to a public hospital, see? A cat would try and eat my snake. Oh, I know. Like, I don't own a cat. I can't have a cat and also a little snake at the same time. But I also can't have a cat in general. Not right now. I can hide a little snake.
They use the Maractus Clinic for their patch-up jobs. Interesting.
Huh.
It looked like something had happened in that park.
Ah, a body was found there in unusual circumstances.
Something more unusual than being dead?
It's not our concern, in any case.
I feel like it's our concern! Right, let's ignore that and find that noodle stand.
Whatever happened to professional curiosity?
Thanks. Really. If I get tired of sleeping, maybe I'll head down to this Maractus place. Maybe hit him up for some reparations. A little legal action would do me some good. Holy shit.
I was wondering when I get paid? We solved the case of your accident and found a missing article of clothing.
My panties!
That leaves the noodle stand.
Feel
free to drop in if you get stuck. I'll be happy to help with anything not involving money. Oh, he's a broke-ass bitch.
Goodbye, quid pro quo. Hello, pro bono.
Right, back to the office to plan our next move.
Bummer. I wonder if he'll have anything to say about... Hey, we found your mirror. Check this out. So this was the thing that led you to the car.
Yes, sir. The mirror you knocked off was just the clue we needed.
Good work, Apollo. Of course, you might say. I was the one who made solving that case possible.
You don't get points for knocking off a car mirror.
He's so cute.
He's so cute.
Junie, the type of gal who knows how a singular spaghetti is called. Huh? Show him your badge?
Okay.
What's that? Looks strangely familiar.
How could you not recognize an attorney's badge?
It's been 7 years. I've forgotten a lot of things.
I guess some 7 years are longer than others.
Ugh.
Oh, Phoenix! Phoenix! Come on, man.
Thoughts on this phone?
It just ignores me.
All right, I guess we're going back to the office.
Oh shit! You're the woman from the Kataki place!
Yeah.
I knew it! Something's the matter and you want our help, right? Well, you come to the right place. This way, please.
Thank you. My name's Alita Tiala.
Oh, God.
My name is Alita Tiala. I have a request.
Your request? Let me guess. Something's been stolen?
Your flyer? It says, now defending. So I thought...
What? You mean, you want me to defend you? Me? Maybe you can tell us what happens? Were you hit by a car? Did someone steal your stands or your panties?
No. I'm not the client, actually. The client would be my, fiancé, I suppose you would call him.
Fiancé? What happened to him then?
He was arrested this morning. The charge was murder.
Finally, a character Juni can simply naturally talk to voice them.
Murder.
Have you heard about what happened at the park?
So, what's your story? You frequent the Kataki Mansion, yeah? Are you a member of their, organization?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
You see, I'm to be married next month to the boss's son.
The boss's son? So he's a gangster?
Yeah, but the Katakis are locally responsible gangsters. I thought it'd be nice for a change, quit my boring job, live a good gangster life.
I love her.
I think you're onto something. Mrs. Kataki, I like the sound of that. I'm not sure your daddy would care much for that. What happens?
I haven't told all the details, but I know that a body was found in the park, near the Kataki Mansion.
There were a lot of police cars there.
Apparently, the victim was shot with a pistol. But I hear the circumstances of the shooting were rather unusual.
And your fiancé was arrested for this. What sort of person is your fiancé?
She's such a gangster.
Your fiancé is the Kataki family's only son, correct?
His name's Waki. Waki Kataki. I brought a photo.
Oh, he's cute. He's a little fox.
Well, that's quite the photo.
I know. Oh, and he can be so powerful and menacing, but so cute.
But if he's the boss's only son...
Yeah, I'm sure he'll take his father's place someday.
Say, I'm a boss already of this agency.
Please help my Waki, please.
Right, my first solo defense case. Crime boss's son or not, I'll prove he's innocent.
Have a good one, Jay Dowsel.
I prepared a letter of request. I know you need those.
Right, let's go check out the scene of the crime.
Oh my god. What is this? What is a letter of request? Why does it say hit request?
It's a bit of a lingo, like calling a hit or a hitman.
Oh, you mean gangster talk.
So does hit mean to defend in gangster-esque? Well, hitman?
I certainly hope not.
Something tells me she used the wrong envelope. All right, let's get out of here. We should go here. We should find out what we can. See if we can touch base with her fiance, with Waki. Ah, it's you kids again. Look, can't you find some other place to play?
We're not playing! We're, investigating, aren't we, Apollo?
No, Apollo!
Sir, I have a letter of request here.
Letter of... huh? Why does it say hit request on it? Apollo, you dumb bitch!
Miss Talia must have used the Kitaki stationery.
Excuse me, coming through. Oh, shit! It's you, Mr. Gavin.
Who's this guy?
Right, Kristoff. Yeah, okay, that's where I got the name. That's where I got the name Gavin from. He's German? Wait, I don't...
Shit, I don't... I can only...
Wait, okay, hold on. Hang on, chat. Hang tight, hold my hand. How is he out of jail? Spoiler alert, Kristoff has a twin brother. And that's where I got the name Gavin from. Because when at the beginning of the stream, when I was trying to figure it out, because Gavin is his twin. Yeah. I know that's like a less interesting conclusion, but I know he's like an important character. Okay, just hang on a minute, chat. Just...
together. We are better than ever.
Okay, there's an ad. Just listen, Disney. I haven't reinstalled Adblock since they started fucking with YouTube.
Hello, I'm Gareth Jameson. I'm an actor and a voice coach from www.londonvoicelessons.com.
Hang on.
Here are some tips for working on your voice.
hang on. Bro, I do not need to see your intro. Today,
or maybe you want to impress your friends. Or if you're learning German, practicing a German accent while you're speaking English might help you with your accent while you're speaking German. Whatever the reason, playing with accents is a-
Tutorials work, chat, okay? Just give me, it is less than 2 minutes.
Now the key to any accent is to isolate the sounds that are specific to that accent.
So I know they do Z,
W and V,
right? They do Z instead of the, right?
They both sound like a V. So let's listen to this. Vi is the voice like vine.
Vi is the voice like
wine. Vi is the voice like wine. But now it's Vi is the voice like vine.
Vi is the voice like vine. Like, what is that last word he's saying?
Notice also that on the word the in the voice, the TH sound has changed to a Z. In fact, it's very common for German speakers to change the TH sound
vice
to Z
versa,
or S.
Yeah.
This is because there is no TH sound in German.
No way this is happening right now.
Native language.
No.
So,
what do they do with their vowels?
Thank you so much for this.
Thank you so much for this. Whatever. We can't do this, man. We can't. This isn't going to work. I know I could just speak like Egghead, but this is an important character. He's gonna be around. We have to nail his character. We have to nail his voice.
Thank you so much for this.
Thank you so thank much you. For this.
Thank you. And this.
This.
It also helps me when I do my German accent to make it a little bit more hissy.
They're like a little, it's like a little flamboyant. It's like, it, like you know the pit, like the pigs from Shrek? Go like, yeah! The three little pigs. I can't do it, man. I must say, I'm used to being inspected by the ladies. Yeah! German sounds slutty. I'm gonna be real! I know actual Germans don't sound like that, but there's a quintessential
like funny German voice in like a lot of media, like Egghead from Disco, like the pigs from Shrek. Like, just say Wunderwag a couple times. I can't.
I must say, I'm used to being inspected by the ladies.
I'm just gonna give him like a flamboyant voice. I'm not gonna try to do a German accent.
But this is the first time I felt this way with a man.
Oh, wow.
Mr. Gavin?
Ah, Fräulein. Fräulein. What is a sweet morsel like you doing in such a dismal place? Can I help?
Yes!
The policeman officer fellow here won't let us in!
We even have a letter of request!
You must be exhausted standing out here.
Fräulein. Okay, thank you. Fräulein. Fräulein.
I will take you to the scene of the crime.
Oh, really?
By your leave, officer.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir.
Very well. This way, Fräulein.
Fräulein. Fräulein. Roll the R. Is it like a click or like a roll?
Fräulein.
Whee!
So are we gonna ask...
Hey, what about me?
On that note, enjoy your investigation.
Thank you. Will we see you again?
Ask the wind, Fräulein. I'll be riding on it.
He's so funny. What the fuck?
Who was that? Apollo, look! A corpse! What? Hey, it's just a mannequin. Wow, it sure got me.
Might I exactly ask what it is you're doing here?
Oh, it's you. How did you kids get in here?
Oh, this guy. Well, he was more like a prince, really. He let us in.
Him again.
That glimmerous fop always getting in my way.
He is a fop! He is a fop!
Anyway, the scene is off limits.
Excuse me? We have a letter of request.
One moment.
Why is she holding that big magnifying glass?
I'd recognize that handwriting anywhere. Scientific analysis says this was written by Elita Tiala.
Thanks. It took you 30 minutes to figure that out. So, what's up with the mannequin there?
It's taking the place of the body, preserving the scene of the crime as it was found.
What the fuck?
What's a fop? A fop is like a... Okay, it's like a really old term for like an upper-class feminine man. But it's like a really old term. Like, I'm not talking like... I'm not talking like early 2000s. I'm talking like 1800s. So Joel? Is Joel a fop? I don't know.
The body was pulling the stand?
Oh, probably older than 1800s. Yeah, way older.
So you're a defense attorney, are you?
Detective Emma Sky. I'm in charge of the crime scene.
She doesn't seem that happy about it.
She doesn't seem that happy about many things.
I trust you know how to stay out of the way. I always carry two pairs of handcuffs, just in case.
Wink.
Detective Sky?
Quiet, please. It's snack time.
Real? Awesome. Love that. Love that for her.
We're not making much progress here. She must not be very busy.
I never seem to get a lucky break. Back after 9 years, and they still won't give me the position I requested. And then I hear he gave up the defense attorney life.
He? Who's he? An ex-defense attorney? Detective Sky?
Quiet, please. It's snack time.
We're not making much progress here.
Huh, all right. Well, maybe we should just investigate first. Nice to see you though, Emma.
She's so funny.
Hey there, no messing with the crime scene.
But we need to investigate.
Apollo, look, that stand.
Yes, we know.
It says Eldoon.
I've noticed. Well, we've solved the case of the missing stand at least.
Ramen, rice ball.
Though the circumstances could stand to be better.
Enemy stand. Emma!
Investigations are to be carried out by professionals, scientifically.
She's not gonna let us check out the crime scene, is she?
Hey, Apollo, my very unscientific analysis tells me that something here is very suspicious.
I think I know what you mean. It's kind of hard not to notice. I better check out what we came here to find, at least.
What do you mean? We can't examine the knife. Look, Emma won't let us.
Emma!
Hi, thank you for the raid, Alex. Welcome. Welcome, readers. We're right in the middle of case 2, Apollo Justice.
Ah, snack time. Yes, okay.
We should probably show her the badge or something. Yeah. I know we need to show her something. I just don't really know.
If you could spare a moment to look at this.
Can't you say that I'm extremely, extremely busy?
Alright, that doesn't quite work. Love me a bitch who can eat. Are you a bitch that nibbles or a bitch that eats? Cause I'm a bitch that eats. I'm a bitch that munches. None of these are gonna fucking do anything for her. She's not gonna give a shit. Unless... Yeah, no. Present panties. Wait, what if we were like, hey, we're here about the stand, though. Nah, she doesn't, it doesn't work.
Gah!
Alright, maybe it's just not the right time yet.
I can't believe we're getting donut walled by her. That's so fucked up.
The nameplate.
Taki, that's so cool. Short and blunt, like any good gangster. Ooh, let's change our name. How about WAA? Maybe that's too short and blunt. What do you think? No comment.
Have a good winter and burn.
Huh?
Hope and I haven't been on speaking terms for a while.
I don't know. Fuck. I don't know how to get through to her. Help! 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 Thoughts on these panties? Thoughts on this phone?
I'm not sure I understand.
We were missing something. Detention center. Oh, right. We had to go to the detention center.
Polly, you look as happy as a clam in its shell.
Aw.
For a lawyer, this is it. The place where the battle begins.
Oh, you need something?
Yeah, we're attorneys. I was hoping we could see Mr. Walkie Kataki.
Walkie Kataki? Walkie Talkie? Sorry, he's in questioning right now. Could take a while.
Drat. Oh well, guess we'll have to come back later then. So much for that battle.
Fuck! God damn it! Son of a bitch! Shit! Fuck! We have to get through MS Sky somehow. Language? Maybe we can re-examine some of this now.
She's still causing trouble.
Look, no one goes in! That means you!
Oh, what's the difference? Let me go!
Ow! Ow, 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 ow! Oh, shit. Sorry.
That's it! I'm suing! But I might change my mind for $5.
What is she, some kind of con artist? Is that a leak? Is that a leak and some... an IV drip? Going into the leak? A sick leak? No!
Got a rhythm, actually. Maybe he plays in a band. Fuck.
Emma! 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 Let me through! Emma! Emma! Maybe... you think Phoenix is back by now? Probably not, right? Cool Junie noises. Oh, maybe we can pick up the slippers now that we have the magic panties. Maybe, maybe. That'd be cool if they let us. We've already searched through the trash. We've already done it, Trucy. Wait, what? Wait, but how am I supposed to get the slippers now? Trucy! Trucy! Emma! Why am I being blocked? Why am I being donut-walled? I'm going fucking crazy. Maybe we should still just try to examine shit. Even though Emma's gonna cock block us. Oh shit, that's a leaf. Wait a minute. Wait, that's a fucking. Listen, hear me out, okay? Listen, it's a. Listen, guys, the leaves. The leaves. Guys, listen. Guys, listen. Yeah, they
guys, is the same fucking shape as the leaf that was on the bottom of the slipper. Do you understand? Actually, you know what? We can probably go to, there's a leaf in the park. Incredible news. You guys don't get the fucking point. You don't get the fucking idea.
Oh, Mr. Aldoon. Hello?
Looks like he left.
You're gonna blow the case wide open. We found a stand at everything. What about our free bowl?
Oh, too bad. Looks like we'll have to wait a little longer for that bowl. So sorry.
Aw, what a bummer. Fuck! He also left! I can't believe this is happening to me. Why is this happening to me? To me, Juniper. At least this cat is still here. Maybe we should go talk to Phoenix again. That might be what we have to do. Phoenix, help! Ah, you're back. Run into some problems? Yeah!
Oh, Polly, didn't you want to tell Daddy something?
Oh, me? No, I'm fine, really.
What's this? So there is a problem.
No, no problem. Actually, I got a defense request.
A defense request? That is a problem.
Huh?
I've given up the court. I'm not a lawyer anymore.
The request was for me!
Oh, right. You're a lawyer, aren't you?
He's doing that on purpose. I know it.
You fucking dick.
Murder. Murder. Apollo takes out a knife. I'll show you a real crime scene.
I'll show you a real crime scene, Phoenix!
So what about this defense request?
It's related to the murder in People Park, actually.
Guess what? We found Mr. Eldu's noodle stand at the scene of the crime.
Did you know? That's unusual indeed. Never heard of a noodle stand being used as a murder weapon.
I think the murder weapon was something else.
You mean you don't know what the murder weapon was?
That funny detective lady won't let us on the scene. What kind of detective wears a lab coat anyway?
Lab coat? Huh. Didn't think she'd be involved with this.
You know her?
You could say that.
So, you know her, don't you?
I met her on a case. This was about 10 years ago. Okay, so Emma was, she was in the last game of the trilogy, right? So the events that happened that caused Phoenix to stop practicing happened 3 years later, right? Or was she in the second game? No, she was in the third one. She was still a high school student at the time.
That would make her about the same age as me.
That's my daddy. He knows all the police types. Oh, wait. Maybe you know that other guy, too.
That other guy?
That shining prince on the motorcycle.
Prince?
Last case was Emma. Yeah. Yeah, the bonus case, right. Apollo, tell me about this prince of Trucy's. Indulge a concerned father.
He was at the crime scene. He looked just like Mr. Gavin.
Did he know?
You know him?
My guess is he's Christoph Gavin's younger brother. Oh, younger brother, not twin brother.
His brother?
We're acquaintances after fashion. Clavier Gavin. Rock and roll god incarnate. Okay, so I had it right. It wasn't Christoph and Gavin. I got the names confused.
Clavier. What a lovely name. He's so dreamy.
I remember DL6. That was one of my favorite games or cases in the franchise.
I didn't know Mr. Gavin had a brother. What was he doing out there?
I had a feeling you'd be crossing paths again soon. Now, what was the problem again? Having trouble investigating a crime scene in the park?
Yeah, that detective woman won't let us in.
Go to the office. Under the silk top hat, you'll find a bottle of white powder. Phoenix! Try taking that to this detective.
White powder? I hope it's not what I think it is.
Just take it to her. It'll be fine. You'll see. Oh, and tell her I said hi. Phoenix! Come on, man. We're gonna get him a hook!
So this must be that silk top hat. Let's take a closer look. Huh? Whoa! You know what this is, Trucy? I remember finding some in Daddy's dresser when I was little. I thought it was sugar, so I licked it. He got mad at me. This is getting more and more suspicious.
Mysterious white powder with the alleged ability to improve Detective Sky's mood. Uh-huh.
She's sure to know what that white powder is.
Okay, whatever. I don't care. This is none of my business. I'm just an attorney. Is MSG white? I wouldn't know. Alright, Emma. I got your fix, girl.
Ah! Is that? It couldn't. Where'd you get that? I brought it from the office. You work at Wright & Co. Law Offices, yes? Yeah, sort of. Detective Sky, how do you know my daddy? Daddy? I'm sorry, who did you say you were? Trucy Wright, Phoenix Wright's daughter. What? Mr. Wright has a daughter?
You seem shocked.
Well, you're Mr. Wright's daughter and you're his apprentice. Then I'm available to help you in any way I can. Thanks. This powder is used for detecting fingerprints. Fingerprints? I guess you might call it a memento from the time I spent with Mr. Wright.
Yeah, fingerprint.
White powder memories. If you find any evidence with fingerprints on it, please let me know. We'll dust for prints. Wow, she's quite the eager beaver all of a sudden.
Yay! Now we can talk! Yay!
The report came in late last night. The body was found much as you see it now. Except it was a real body. But why? Why was a body pulling a noodle stand? If I knew the answer to that, I wouldn't still be here. Well, what was the cause of death? A bullet wound to the temple. He was shot by a pistol. A pistol? Not the easiest thing to come by in this day and age. Unless you're a cop or a gangster. Incidentally, the victim's name was Paul Maractus.
Oh shit! Pal Maractus.
I just received the autopsy report, in fact.
Yeah, noodle guy fucking snapped.
I mean, really, what's up with this case? It's enough to make me want to run off, pulling a mysterious noodle stand behind me.
Not so mysterious, actually. We should tell her, Apollo. After all, we know where the stand came from.
A likely story. I didn't come here to play games, you know. Actually, we do know where the noodle stand came from. The noodle stand's owner is...
I don't know.
Take that!
Take that! Emma and Trucy do look kind of similar.
Nah, there's nothing there.
This is the proprietor of Eldon's Noodles, Mr. Eldoon himself. He's famous in this part of town. Not bad. I guess Mr. Wright picked the right kids for the job. That saved me a lot of work. Thanks. What sort of person was the victim anyway? You mean, what did he do? He was a doctor. A doctor?
Yeah, he dead as hell. Got mixed up with the wrong crowd.
Who, me? I'm just a supervisor for this crime scene. Detective Sky. I was out of the country for a while. I came back to be a forensic scientist.
Oh, were you studying abroad?
Something like that. I was studying in Europe. Forensic sciences, mind you. But when I got back here, they threw me in criminal affairs, just like that.
Why didn't you just become a forensics expert in Europe?
Well, I suppose that was an option, but I had a lot of favors to repay to people back here.
Favors? Wasn't she in high school when she left?
What? What's that look for? I was involved in an incident before I left, but Mr. Wright and his people helped me out. I owed them.
Really? I had no idea. She's been out of the country for a while. She probably doesn't know about Mr. Wright's current state of affairs. I mean, she does. She says she's like mad that he like stopped fucking, you know, doing law.
Could you tell us a bit about the defendant? He's the only son of the Kotaki family, yes?
Waki Kotaki. I don't know if he's the boss's son, but he's certainly throwing his weight around.
Violently. In the detention center.
I see.
Why wasn't he arrested in the first place?
You are a defense attorney, aren't you? You're not his, by any chance.
Actually, yes. I am.
Well, we have a witness to the moment of the crime.
Huh?
The witness called the police. They'll be testifying during the trial tomorrow.
What?
Uh-oh. We're screwed. It's over. Our career is over! Is Trucy Wright's biological daughter? Because if that's the case, she's 10 years max. No. Phoenix technically could have had Trucy when he was like 18, but Trucy is definitely not Phoenix's real daughter.
Could you tell us more about the victim?
Well, let's see. Apparently he's the physician at a clinic in the area. Quite well off too, from the sound of it. The clinic's name is the Maractus Clinic.
Maybe that's why the cop car was parked there?
We don't know who Trucy's biological parents are. We just met her. We'll probably find out more about her later.
What? You've been to the clinic? Yeah, though on a related issue. I see. So that means Dr. Maractus stole the stand and pulled it all the way here?
That would seem to be the case.
But why?
Don't ask me.
Yeah, what the fuck?
God, I fucking love Ace Attorney cases. They are so weird. They're so fucking strange.
It's a knife. A shiv, to be precise. Ooh, lingo.
The defendant, Waki Kotaki, is the son of known gangsters. The police are assuming this belongs to him.
Wait, but wasn't the murder weapon a pistol? Huh? Look at this. There's a handprint on this shiv.
A handprint? Then there might be a fingerprint. Let's investigate.
Broop.
Right. First, choose the fingerprint you want to examine.
Choose a fingerprint?
Look closely at the handle. That's right. Pick the one you want to analyze.
The big dark one.
Yeah.
Right, let's get detective.
First, sprinkle some aluminum powder over the print. With a press of space like this, see? The oil left by the print absorbs the aluminum powder so you can just dust it on. And blow it off.
Blow? It's like whistling. You know how to whistle, don't you?
Just use R and...
Wow, amazing! It's like magic!
Isn't it, though? Incidentally, it's important that you cover the entire fingerprint with the powder.
Huh? What? Huh? Wait, dust what for... Dust what for prints?
Blow. Oh shit, I got it, somehow. I think.
Good, clear, quite impressive. Next, to match the prints.
The police office has samples, so you can tell who the figure is using whom. That doesn't sound like as much fun as actually finding the print. Oh fuck, why did I turn... I think I turned on autoplay accidentally.
Okay, pick the person whose print you think this is. You probably have a good idea whose knife this is already.
Do I?
Oh no. Yeah, they sure are matching. Well, maybe they aren't. Well, yeah, they are. Have a good night, Reagan.
So, the fingerprints do belong to the defendant.
Yes, isn't it amazing? The power of science. It's my life.
Apollo, she's sparkling.
And I'm dimming.
Look sharp, spirits up. The real fight is yet to come.
Chin up, Polly. The trial hasn't even started and I'm already losing.
Bummer. Bummer. Why the fuck? What?
This mannequin is dressed up to look like a police officer. I've seen one at the station. A mannequin in place of a body.
The body of the victim has already been removed.
You think the victim was the noodle stand thief?
What, you think someone killed him because he stole it?
Yeah. Taking care of business. Little Plum Kataki style.
Try not to sound too eager about that, please. Bucket. Bucket.
And this is Mr. El Dude's noodle stand, obviously. It does say El Dude in big letters, doesn't it? And that mark on his paper lantern there looks familiar. It's going to be a little weird telling him, what with the corpse and all. Anyway, that wraps up three of our cases.
That's right, congratulations, Apollo.
And leaves us with one case that's worse than all three put together. Murder. Bum bum bum.
Blue tarps have been placed on the ground around the stand.
Apollo, I bet the victim was going to have a picnic here.
Tracy.
I guess he could have eaten all the noodles he wanted.
Don't touch those. Those are preserving the crime scene.
Oh, I guess the police put these tarps here after all.
Hey! I don't know, that's kind of weird, right? That's kind of weird, right? Because, El Dude also uses a blue tarp to cover up his noodle stand. Is it just a coincidence?
There's gotta be a clue or two around here.
You and your trash cans, go ahead, knock yourself out!
Please, can't you see that I'm doing my... Huh?
Look, another pair of underwear!
Wow, Apollo, you're a genius at finding panties!
Stop saying that! Wait, these aren't...
They're not mine!
Could these have been stolen too?
So, have you met the defendant?
No.
Visiting hours are almost over at the detention center. You might think about wrapping up here and heading over.
Good idea.
I don't know what good it'll do. We have a witness and a knife with prints. Have I mentioned I've got a bad feeling about this?
Don't worry. It's like a rite tradition.
Some traditions I could live without. Alright.
Okay. I'm gonna go talk to the defendant. After we talk to him, though, I'm probably gonna call it. Because I can only talk for 3 hours straight before I start to become injured. Before I become wounded. I'd be shitting myself if my defense attorney is 15 years old. Yo, this guy doesn't fucking know about fuck Franzia. Francisca von Karma. Yeah, she was a rival prosecutor in the original trilogy, and I think she was 15. She's fucking cool. Meeting hours for the day are all done. No! Yeah, the whip lady? Oh, yeah. Oh, she started at 16. She's older when you meet her, though. Isn't she still only, like, 18, though? Because, like the whole... Like, her whole point was that, like... Yeah, okay. So I guess she just started when she was 15 or 16. Yeah, my bad. Because, like, her whole point was that she was, like, a young genius.
But we... Still 3 minutes!
I'll put in your request, but don't expect anything. The father's talking in the private room with him. Oh, no. Uh-oh.
The father? You mean, like, a priest?
I mean the suspect's father. Mr. Winfred Big Wins Kataki himself. Die, you! You're the one on your way out, old... Ah, they're here. Jesus!
Whoa, this guy radiates power!
Oh...
With a cute apron?
Yuwaki's lawyer?
Yes, sir!
Well, I'm Big Wins Kataki. It took his eyes! That was what made me go like, ah! Fourth head of the Kataki family. Capiche?
Actually, I came to speak to your son.
Mr. Justice.
Yes?
My son's innocent. He killed no one. My son's innocent. He killed no one. Is that more? He killed no one. If he were found guilty, it wouldn't be good. Capiche?
Yes, I'm all about capiching. Capiching loud and clear.
You gotta do more than just understand to make it. You'll learn, though. Even if the lesson comes at the end of your short life. I can't do it, man.
What's the big idea, old man? I need...
So cute! Look at him! Look at him! He's just a little fox! He's just a little fox!
What? Stop! Stop looking at me like that! Stop it, chat!
Okay, I know he's not Italian, but he's a mob boss! Listen to the music! Listen to the fucking music! Me and my twinks.
You can't treat me like a kid no more. Not now. You know why? I wanted to go to the clink. I like it here.
You must be walkie.
A G's not a G till he does hard time. Bizoy.
Bizoy.
You'll see, when I get out of here, things will change. Silence!
My apologies, Mr. Justice. He's usually such a nice boy.
Forgive me if I have a hard time believing that.
You can't take me under your wing this time, old man. You heard me. I don't need no trial. I did it!
I think that's enough for today, Mr. Justice. Don't let me down tomorrow.
So much for talking to our client. But we made so much progress today. We even found my panties. I had fun, at least. Of course, the biggest mystery of all remains. How am I supposed to build a case for the trial? Oh, almost forgot. It's time for my show. Tonight, I'm performing at the Wonder Bar. You should come and check it out. Is that where you pull a thing out of your panty? Is that...
Oh, they're to be continuing me.
Oh, shit. Does that mean it's...
I technically have 15 minutes. It doesn't matter. We go. 15 minutes. I at least want to get my foot in the door. Why are we already in court? Why are we already in court?
Huh. Mr. Wright's not here today? He said his old foot injury is acting up.
Old injury? He was all smiles yesterday.
Yes, he smiled when he said we'd be fine. As long as you're there, Trucy.
Yeah, fine. We'll be fine. Here comes justice! I started my voice training at 5 this morning.
Ooh, do some now. I want to see. Here.
Huh? Oh, okay. My name is Apollo Justice, and I'm fine!
That sounds more like a self-mantra than voice training.
I'm fine, you know what I'm saying. Oh, shit. Good morning.
Yo, sup? Hit me with the guilty verdict, G, see if I care. You just hang loose and let things go with the flow. You know what I'm saying?
Yourself before every stream. I be like looking in my mirror and shit, going like,
you're a golden god. You're a seed of darkness in a world. You're a fucking.
You're the mouth that will consume all.
Not really.
Walkie, don't be running your mouth like that in here. See, that's the difference between me and you, old man. I ain't afraid of no cops. Real G's can't keep it real till they spend some hard time in the pen.
You have absolutely no idea what you're talking about.
Sounds like they've both been voice training too, Apollo.
My worst fears realized.
He's so cute! Guys, help!
The trial's starting and I haven't had a real talk with my client.
He's so cute, he's a little rascal.
Court is now in session for the trial of Walkie Kotaki.
Oh my god, I don't like, listen guys, do I need to say this shit out loud? Don't come to my chat saying you were banned in someone else's chat. Come on, man. Like, my mods will insta-ban you, fucking troublemaker.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Oh shit!
Ready to rock and roll, Herr Judge. Herr Judge? Herr?
It's him, the guy from yesterday. He's a prosecutor. It's Mr. Gavin's brother.
Long time no see, Prosecutor Gavin. Were you taking a leave of absence?
I feel like maybe I should give the judge a voice. I've just been talking, doing him in a normal voice.
You know that little band I started in my free time? Thing is, we got real popular. Hard to say nine to your fans when three of your singles go platinum, yeah.
I see. To be honest, I was a little concerned.
I fear you might still be distraught over that one trial.
Not to worry. Here to...
What? How do you... What is air? Hair? Hair judge? Here judge? Her judge? Air?
Air judge. I wouldn't miss this day in court for the world. It's worth even more than VIP passes to one of my concerts, yeah. How could I pass up a chance to see the true strength of the little boy who bested my brother? It was worth canceling a show or two.
Understood.
I'm not trying to be German. No, I can't do a German accent. We tried to be German earlier. I'm just giving him like a gay-ass flamboyant voice. Because, like, he did intro, like, he did, like, that was how he introduced himself. What do I say?
Before that, I was thinking, is the air in this courtroom not a bit serious?
It is a court of law.
There's no way to get the crowd jumping, air judge.
They're not supposed to jump. This is a courtroom.
Achtung, baby! Today we play it my way! Wait, I love him. Achtung!
What's that noise?
Sometimes you have to get up in order to get down to prosecuting.
This is crazy.
The victim, Paul Maractus, director of the Maractus Clinic. The scene at People Park, he was found pulling a noodle stand.
What in the world was a doctor doing pulling a noodle stand?
Yes, I believe you will only find that out by asking the defendant right here, right now. Because it is an undeniable truth that he shot the victim.
Whoa, we're going too fast. Whoa, wait.
What do you mean undeniable?
If you were to glare at anyone, Air Justice, glare at the punk in the defendant's chair. His crime was witnessed quite clearly, you see.
Very well. Please admit this witness to the court.
Oh, fuck yeah. Fuck yeah! Nine! Not yet. First, there is a little matter to be cleaned up.
Could you talk without the accompaniment? I swear I could see the guitar for a second.
What is it, Prosecutor Gavin?
The motive, Air Judge. Why did the little punk do it? Why did he kill the director of the Maractus Clinic?
Objection!
Not so fast! The defendant doesn't have to explain that!
Oh? But what if the defendant specifically requests to do so, as he did this morning? I want to give a shout out to all my homies, I believe he said.
What? What is right? They always say that on stage, you should hit the crowd with speed and ferocity. Sounds like he got you good, huh, Polly?
Well, this is highly unusual, but... The court will now hear from the defendant concerning his motive in the crime.
What is going on?
So you, son, are the defendant. Waki, are you?
I ain't your son, old man. You step to a Kataki, you best be prepared to step strong.
You step to a public official, you'd best be prepared to step into jail.
You gotta hand that to him, Waki sure has guts. And his guts I'm worried about.
My female beta killed the 12 guppies I got. Why did you let your female beta kill 12 guppies?
I'm like burying my head in my hands. Well then, the court will now hear the testimony on the defendant's motive.
You didn't know it was her. Bro, you... Okay, all right. Kill streak. You should have known. Female betas are maybe not as territorial as male ones, but they're super aggressive. Jesus.
Kill streak.
We had an ick infestation. I thought that's what it was. Oh, damn. Did you, like, catch her, like, mauling one? That's, like, that's fucked up. I don't want to know, actually.
I'll tell you one thing, that doctor was a quacker. Somebody had to show him what's what. I was in his clinic about half a year ago. He messed up my OP something bad. My op. Something bad. Op? And then he just lets me go without a word. See you later. Bye. So I gotta go in, get another doc to patch me up again. That was the day I done figured it out. No OG's gonna let that pass. That's when I went to his pad that night. Know what I'm saying?
You're saying you were one of the victim's patients.
Oh, Reagan's beta doesn't care? Yeah. Some of them just have different personalities.
Lots of stuff goes down when you're keeping it real on the street. True that. I tell you one thing, that doc was whack.
Very well, the defense may begin the cross-examination.
I can't believe this is the first time I'm hearing about all this.
Yeah, I feel like we went into this case wildly underprepared. Like, more so than usual for an Ace Attorney case.
The doctor was a quacker. First of all, the word you're looking for is quack.
And isn't that a little harsh? He's your family doctor.
Who asked you, pointy locks? Just who do you think you are?
Your lawyer?
Look, I ain't trying to hear that. He was a quack of plain and simple.
Does he think he murdered him? Honestly, he might think that he murdered him.
Hold it!
By someone, you mean... Was there anyone with a score to settle with this doctor? Besides you, I mean...
You better ask somebody else, Holmes. What do I care? I made up my own mind and did what had to be done, straight gangsta style.
But why were you mad at this doctor?
Yo, sit back and listen while I drop it, J-Man. I was in his clinic about half a year ago. He messed up my op something bad.
Hold it!
So you were a patient at the Maractus clinic half a year ago? For what reason?
I have what you might call a mark of honor.
Can you explain precisely what was wrong?
Need a little run in it with the Rivalis family. That's when I pulled a jack move. Oh shit! Ran into an ambush and she busted a cap right in me.
Oh shit. Got shot?
According to my sources, you couldn't stand the stress of waiting. And ran in 15 minutes before the appointed time. By yourself.
Hey, I was more than a match for those guys!
So you were carried to the Maractus clinic from there? Apparently, he was shot in the heart.
Shot in the heart and he's still alive? I can catch bullets between my teeth! That's awesome, Trucy!
But I never learned how to catch them with my heart!
That's out of pocket.
The boy stopped just short of my thumper. Would've been golden if it weren't for that whack doc. Can't even take out a stupid bullet.
So, as you say, the surgery was a failure.
That ain't all of it, Holmes. And then he just lets me go without a word. See you later, bye!
What do you mean, he just let you go without a word?
What do you think it means? It's whack, that's what.
Not sure what that means, but it sounds bad.
It sounds as though our doctor wished to hide his mistake. That is why he let the defendant go.
He's a liar, straight up! He's a badder G than me! So I gotta go away and get another doctor to patch me up again!
So this bullet is still...
You know it, I could still feel it! Right there in my chest, pressing up against my heart.
Your words are like a bullet shot straight into my heart. Or something to that effect. Incidentally, that's one of our hit singles.
That's so cool, Clavier.
Well, that sounds like a straightforward case of malpractice. Word, Shave Man. We're no accident, that's for shizzle.
Seems like there were issues with this doctor.
Man, putting him down was like doing the world a favor.
Walkie, please consult your lawyer before saying things like that.
Chin up, Apollo. Back straight.
Why did this mistake only come to the light that day?
It was found during the family health checkup.
The family checkup?
That was the wackiest thing of all. All of his G's lining up, taking eye exams and all that. Better to die young than fade away, bizoy!
A relief to hear.
What's a relief?
Oh, did your father not tell you? That bullet you carry so close to your heart, if not attended to immediately, it could kill you.
What?
What's going on? What's happening? What is this case? Yes, if Dr. Maractus had knowledge concerning this ticking time bomb in you. Knowledge that could have saved your life. I know all of this is going to be relevant. That's just like how this case is just like off the wall though.
No way, that's whacked.
There is proof. Your checkup report. How ironic that you would kill the one man capable of helping you. You're almost as careless as he was. Well, now that the place is hopping, let's get this gig started.
Started?
We've had enough of a warm-up act, yeah? Time to hear from the witness.
Walkie sure is quiet all of a sudden. I'm a little uneasy myself. Is this Gavin's strategy?
So, you will tell us your name and occupation. Hang on, guys. Listen.
Oh.
Okay, get this. My name is Wesley Stickler. By occupation, oh my god. Unemployed, however, we must acknowledge the meaning of identity, which is commonly attached to this notion of occupation. Which is accepted this reality or confusion is not gestalt per se, but vagueness inherent in all representations of thought. By which he means to say that he is a student. Yeah, I'm gonna give them the same voice. And... a junior at Ivy University, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, in the Department of Science and Engineering. Filled with curiosity for all things, I spent my days in pursuit of truth, honing my...
Herr Stickler, please direct said curiosity to the case at hand today.
This courtroom is so fucking slutty. My god, man.
Please testify to the court about what you saw on the night of the crime.
You ask quite simplistically what I saw. However, we must understand that the Homo sapiens possess two eyes that is designed to receive and interpret data, sending images of the forms of...
Being in college is his entire personality.
Oh shit, can I save?
One man pulling a stand, another man facing him. I saw them quite clearly. The man facing the victim was the defendant. In his hand he held, yes, a pistol. It was pointed at the man pulling the stand. A shot! The bullet hit the man pulling the stand from the front, square in the forehead.
Was there anyone else in the park at that time?
I could say with 100% accuracy that there was not.
The pistol our witness refers to is the cacket.
I need to give the different voices, don't I?
No, whatever.
The court accepts this into evidence.
Very well, Mr. Justice, you may cross-examine the witness.
Yes? No.
Tracy, why are you staring like that at the witness?
That man? I can't help but feel like I've seen him somewhere before. Don't tell me he's the panty thief!
He can't be the panty thief.
This guy? What interest would he have in women's underwear?
Can I please save?
Oh, yes, I can. Okay. Chat, I'm out of here. I have to go. I have to leave. I have to get dinner, and then I have to hang out with some friends and play games because it's Saturday. I gotta go. But, I'll be back tomorrow. It's technician time, baby. Who do we raid? It's a good question. Oh, what? Do you have plans on a weekend? Yeah, they're just starting kind of late. That was a great stream. When are you going to do more? Next Saturday. Next Saturday we continue. We could raid Grimmy? Yeah, let's raid Grimmy. Actually, did we raid Grimmy really recently? Does anyone remember? If we raided Grimmy super recently, then Millia. She's having a subathon? Oh. It's just I swear we raided Grimmy like last week. Either way, either of those are fine. Thank you, mods. I'm out of here. Thank you guys for hanging out with me tonight. I had fun. I love Ace Attorney. Millia's sleeping right now. Oh, okay, then Grimmy is fine. Yeah. I will see you guys tomorrow. I hope you guys... sleep well. I kiss the homies goodnight. Mwah! And I'm out of here. Bye-bye! Bye-bye!